Hi, I'm Siddhanjay from Singapore. I work as a software engineer at Delivery Hero, and I'll be talking about scaling the Ethereum blockchain. The Ethereum community is by far the most active developer community for any public blockchain, processing over 1.2 million transactions per day, and with a network valued over $200 billion. There are more than 11,000 nodes running worldwide with a very high degree of decentralization. The number of users on Ethereum are accelerating at a rapid pace. The recent user surge can be attributed to the growth in DeFi or decentralized finance, where users are able to create entire economies in a trustless manner. But not everything is looking great for Ethereum right now. Ethereum is based on proof-of-work consensus model, which is great for security but uses a lot of the world's energy and is not sustainable. To address this, Ethereum will be moving to a proof-of-stake model in the near future as a part of ETH2 upgrade. Right now, the Ethereum network is very congested due to the high demand, which drives up the gas fees, making transactions costly to process. The biggest challenge is of scalability. Right now, Ethereum can process only 15 to 45 transactions per second, which is quite low. Before we look at the scalability solutions, we need to understand the blockchain scalability trilemma. Although not proven mathematically, it states that between scalability, security, and decentralization, blockchains can choose to have only two of these characteristics. The third one comes at the expense of the other two. Ethereum chooses to be a decentralized and secure while sacrificing scalability as a trade-off. But there are still ways that would enable Ethereum to scale. We can categorize them broadly as layer 1 and layer 2 solutions. Layer 1 is modifying the underlying blockchain itself to have a higher transaction capacity. We could try to increase the block size, but this is quite challenging as it would lead to a more centralized network since not everyone can run a huge node. Ethereum is solving this problem by sharding the chain as a part of the ETH2 upgrade. The other way for improving the scalability is to change the way users are interacting with the blockchain, which are termed as layer 2 solutions. So instead of submitting all activities, the user would perform the bulk of their activity off-chain, and the main chain needs to verify everything happening off-chain is according to the rules. Let's look at sharding. Right now, every single node has to store the entire state and process all the transactions. So sharding is an attempt to solve the scalability trilemma to a certain extent by creating new shard chains which can communicate with the main beacon chain. And each of these shards process only a certain percentage of all transactions to spread the network's load. Now, each validator only needs to process the data of the shard they are validating instead of validating the entire network. State channels. These are a layer 2 scaling mechanism, which is ideal when there are a group of participants who want to make multiple transactions between themselves. They would lock the current state on the main chain, create a new channel where they can settle all the transactions off the main chain. They can close the channel once they are done and submit the final balances to the chain to verify. Rollups is another great layer 2 solution. Rollups work by bundling or rolling up sidechain transactions into a single transaction and generating a cryptographic proof which is sent to the main chain instead of sending the entire data. The proof is also called a snark. There are two main types of rollups. ZK rollups, which uses zero-knowledge proofs as the cryptographic proof generation mechanism, and the other is the optimistic rollups. Right now, the Ethereum community is converging towards using rollups to give a big boost to the scalability along with sharding. The future of Ethereum scalability looks something like this. We are right now at 15 to 45 transactions per second. 45 is when all transactions are simple transfers, and 15 is when those include complex privacy preserving transactions. With rollups, we could be able to support about 1000 to 4000 TPS. Once sharding is completed, the TPS expected to be between 25 to 100k when used along with rollups. Thank you. I am available here to take a few questions.